option. We've also, my husband does a lot of video for World Press Meetup and for work camps here in Boston and also in Providence. So we're kind of really embedded into this community. And so today I want to just talk a little bit about plugins. It's a pretty basic class. But if you're not more familiar with WordPress, then it's a good introduction to what plugins can do for you. So what we'll cover today is plugins versus widgets, some suggested free plugins, some other plugins that I like to use. Then we'll go through really quickly how to find plugins on WordPress.org. A little bit about backup and plugins, and then a little bit about security of plugins. So, when you talk about plugins, you say, what kind of functionality are you looking for, other than the WordPress, the stock WordPress? So right now there's 32 plus thousand plugins on WordPress.org. And 717 million downloads of plugins on the web. Yes?
Another question on plugins. Do the descriptions or do plugins affect the responsiveness of the underlying template or interfere with that? Is a way to tell at the top level?
It depends on what the plugin does.
So that is a no answer.
So no, basically no. And you can't tell in advance, necessarily. Okay, so what's the difference between plugins and widgets? A large part of the flexibility of WordPress comes from both plugins and widgets. A plugin, the definition is it extends the functionality of WordPress. It's something that's being installed and activated on the site versus widgets, which are placeholders on your site or in your theme. And it affects the visible data on your site. So that's kind of the basics. So plugins can do things like adding menus, configure options to the admin dashboard. It can be a spam filter, it can be e-commerce. There's thousands of different things that plugins can do. It can add new features to the front end of your website, like social sharing tools. And it can change the way your site is displayed to be a mobile site, for example. It can collect stats off of Google or off of WordPress. And it can automate tasks like security and backup. So some suggested free plugins. This one is by Automatic. The first one is Jetpack. And by the way, I'll be posting these slides and they have the links to the actual plugin. So Jetpack, is everybody familiar? Have you seen Jetpack? So it's by Automatic. So one of the great things about it is that it will keep updating as Automatic updates. It's one of those plugins that will very rarely break on you. As WordPress upgrades, they're going to be upgrading that, the Jetpack. So it has lots of features. It has social sharing, it has stats. There's like a whole menu of things you can choose from once you set up Jetpack. So it's a great plugin to have on your site because it has a lot of other things in it. Another one that we like to tell people to do is discuss or intense debate. Both of those improve the comment areas. It makes it easier for people to comment. You can sign in with Facebook or Twitter and things like that. So it just encourages more people to comment. Akismet is Automatic's spam filter, and it's a good one because it learns. So if you get a whole bunch of comments in your posts and you put it into the spam folder, Automatic sees those and goes, oh, I didn't know that these two things were spam, and it remembers it for the next time and for others. Yes?
Would question. If you have discussed turned on, installed and turned on, do you need to have an estimate as well?
Discuss it. It's not really filtering out a lot all the comments. I would say do both. It's really hard. The thing about the Kismet is, for personal, it's free. For business, it's $5 per month. So I know a lot of people that just use it free, but they are a business. And for most of my clients, I tell them to sign up for the business account. Yes. They have not. They have a non-profit category, I believe. But, so next would be the Reiko cache. It improves the speed of your site, and Google likes faster sites. WordPress SEO by Yoast helps improve search. There's basically two different SEO plugins, and I like the one by Yoast. And if you subscribe to his newsletters, they give a lot of good information. If you're not using a Kismet, I would recommend something called anti-spam. It's something that you put on your site and it works behind the scenes. You don't have to capture, you don't have anything that people have to do, but it does cut down on spam. And for free plugins, back, WP-UP-3 is a backup plugin. I will talk about a little bit more about backup later. So there's a ton of different plugins available on WordPress.org/plugins. I will kind of quickly go over that. So some plugins I use that I like. Gravity Forms. It takes forms and it says 99 for business, but I think they just reduced the cost to 80 for the basic. Oh, I'm sorry, no, Becca Buddy is 80. Gravity Forms is 99 for business, but it works with a bunch of different other plugins. So it's a great form. For backing up, I use Backup Buddy. It's a great tool for backing up. I use WP Database Cleaner. You know when you start changing pages and you have like 20 different revisions on your site, this will go in and it'll clean out all those revisions for you. Google Analytics Dashboard for WP. There's a number of them out there, but I found this one to work best and not conflict with other plugins. It will show you your summary of your Google Analytics right in the dashboard. So that it just gives you basic information and then you can click through to your analytics if you want more. I've used WP Touch if your site is not responsive. It gives you a mobile site with the content of your WordPress site. Digitized Pages Lite. I've used often for putting a widget box into a poster page. It's really a nice little plugin. I like a plugin called Testimonial Widgets. There's a lot of testimonial widgets out there, but this one is just very light and clean. Usually I'll use WooCommerce for any e-commerce sites. Right now it's probably the best one that keeps up with things. Oh, I'm sorry, yes, okay, Woo Sidebars. Woo Sidebars gives you, so you have you want to have a different sidebar on your page, but we have just a general sidebar. If you take the plugin for sidebars, you'll make a new sidebar for a page. And so you'll be able to have pages with different sidebars on them. Yes?
The cost of 99 is annual or
annual.
Annual.
Okay. problems with it. Not to say that the other one backup, WCB is a free one. And it's good. I have clients on it. But I've just gotten used to using this one, and it's good, clean. It's great for migrating sites if you do a lot of work with that. And they also have, this one has a malware scan on it too. So it will search your site for any malware.
Using that plugin, will that conflict with the theme layout as you would design Nina?
It shouldn't. I'm not going to say that it never will, but it shouldn't. Okay, so I just thought you might want to know the top 10, or top 12 of it is. So, the business, we talked about WordPress SEO, we talked about Contact Form 7 is very popular. It's different from the gravity forms in that when somebody types in the contact information you want in Contact Form 7 and sends you an email, then it's gone. If you use gravity forms, they'll keep a record of that for you. So, talking about the difference between the paid and the free version. Jetpack for WordPress we already talked about. WordPress security we're going to talk about. It's a security plugin. Mail collect newsletters. I have not ever used this, but it's a plugin that you can start sending newsletters out through WordPress. And obviously it's very popular. Next generation gallery is a photo gallery, and it's very powerful. It has a lot of things going on. I've downloaded it a couple times for clients. They have a hard time using it because they don't understand all the levels. It's very popular. The other SEO package, all-in-one SEO, WP Super Cache. I recommended a different caching plugin, but this one seems to be more popular. WordPress Importer is just if you have a blog someplace else, you use that to import the blogs into WordPress, and it's kind of an automatic thing, so it's not something that anybody would really be using, going and finding and using. But it's up there because it's been downloaded a lot of times. I think security, which used to be better WP security, again, we're going to talk about that one a little later. And Google XML Sitemaps is the last of the 12 that are the most popular on the WordPress network. And so, I'm going to do this Wednesday. So, how do you find plugins? You go to wordpress.org/plugins, and you figure out what kind of functionality you want and what you're looking for. So let's do that. WordPress.org, plugin directory, and let's look for, does somebody have the functionality they want to look for?
Slideshow.
started by all of this. PC slideshow, HPW slide, WordPress easy slides. So there's a number of different ones. So how do we pick which one we're going to try first? Let's click on this one. We're going to look at what it's compatible up to. 3.9.2, that's good. So it's a recent one has been updated recently. Last updated 7.29. There's only been 299 downloads, so that's not a lot. And nobody's rated. So we don't have anybody coming there and saying, oh, this is a great plugin. So that means that it's probably fairly new. And just there's not been a lot of people using it and coming back and commenting. So you also might want to go and look for their support. And there's no support here. Nobody's asked any questions on it.
Do we have a demo page of the plugin where you can see before you click that mode?
They usually don't have a demo page, but you'll be able to see screenshots of the. This one is a bad example because it doesn't have any screenshots, but let's go to something else. Sometimes if you go to the actual website of the developer, they might have something there. But so this one has 3 ratings and it's 5 stars, and that looks pretty good. Let's go and check that out. Again, that's good. Last updated was March. That's been downloaded 9,000 times, so that's a little bit better. And people upgraded. 3 people rated 5 stars. So,
the top one is the demo, it looks like the 18W slideshow.
This is just a picture.
But that's how I sort of say it.
That's the next one down on the list of rooms. So let's look and see if there's been any support. Somebody's asked a question and people have answered back, so that's good. If you're looking for a plugin, it's nice to see the support has been answered. That they've updated it recently, that they've responded to questions, and see how many times it's been downloaded and how people react to it. Yes?
What I know is it's still the most popular and highest rated, because relevance is really only telling you it has those words in the title and stuff, which is pretty random. And with something like slideshow, there are literally thousands of plugins. So why not start with the ones that everybody else is using and found bugs in and have rated? So just by changing the sort order.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that could be done. I was just, giving you a quick example. But yes, you can sort them by most popular, highest rated.
And you actually did a good job of showing some of the things that I would consider red flags. Very few downloads, hardly any ratings.
So this one, WordPress easy slides, has some screenshots. So they're giving you screenshots of the front end and the back end. And you really don't know what this is really saying. Website. Okay, so here, demo URL. This one has a demo. So you just just have to look a little bit? Yes?
It seems like, I don't know, maybe I'm doing something wrong. When I try to look up like that, and then I pick popular, then it picks all the popular, like, can you just try to read it? Seems like that's what happens to me. I don't get the most popular.
If you want to go home and look at something like Twitter feed or a simple PayPal shopping cart and check some different things, that's an interesting thing to do. Okay, so those are the basic plugins. We're going to talk a little bit about how WordPress decides where it decides, just so you know when you go to backup plugins, you'll have a feel for it. So WordPress has files and folders, which is under File Manager, and it also has a database, which is your PHP. In the files and folders is, you know, WordPress core files, themes, plugins, any file updates are all in the folder side. On the database side is all your posts, comments, links, taxonomies and users, all that is stored in the database. If you were to download WordPress from WordPress.org, you would find the zip file. And it has three main folders, WP-admin, WP-content, WP-include. Inside the content, besides your themes, your plugins, and uploads. This is just showing you phpMyAdmin for the database. Your database is different from the files and folders. And there's lots of different tables in there. Unless you really know what you're doing, it's probably not recommended to go into the database and play around too much. So, when you're backing up your site, you should back up your site. You can use a plugin or a service. Backup, WP3 is the free one. We have Backup Buddy, Automatic, which is the parent company of WordPress, also has WordPress. It's a monthly service fee, but it will automatically back up your site for you and store the information. Or you can use your host. There are a number of hosts that say they back up their sites daily or weekly, and that may be enough for you. But just make sure that they're not backing up to the same server that your site is on. So, I have an article from Premium WPMU Dev that talks about a bunch of the free WordPress backup plugins. And again, you'll be able to get those slides. So, security. Always back up and always upgrade your WordPress core themes and plugins. How many people back up their site, whenever they see that little two up there or five up there, you always back up your site? That's good, because usually, but it's like 3.7.2 or 3 or 4, those are usually security upgrades with downs and bugs or something. So you should always try and upgrade everything soon, as soon as you see it. The steps to do that. You first back up your site somewhere. Make sure that you have a backup of what your site was. Then upgrade your themes and plugins first, and then upgrade your WordPress core. Sometimes if you upgrade core first, it does things to plugins. So this is the recommended way. Yes?
That seems to disconnect from the fact that core is going to get automatically backed up.
Core will not get automatically backed up. Core automatically upgrades.
Yeah.
Right now.
That will happen.
But
it's automatic before your themes and plugins are.
You get an email that says that it's going to upgrade, and you should do your plugins and things first. Yes.
And if you set up a scheduled backup, you know, for every couple of days, then that was an issue, which you should probably have.
So for security, the best thing you can do to make your site secure is to have strong passwords at all entry points. So that's not just your WPAdmin, it's your hosting control panel. Usually your host takes care of that and gives you a pretty strong password. The FTP for your site, your WordPress admin, and if you're using admin, don't. There's an easy way to change it. If you install iTheme Security, it's an easy way to get rid of the admin. And you can put in whatever name you want for the user. Delete any plugins that you're not using. This is a bad habit that I do. I like will go, oh, let's try this plugin. I'll try this one, and then it's like, oh, I'm not going to use it because it didn't do what I really wanted it to, and I don't take them out and go back and like, oh, I have like 20 plugins and 5 of them I'm not using. Well, just delete those so that you don't have any security problems. I mean, you could have a plugin that you're not using that's not active, and it can still be a security problem that people are trying to get into your site. And this is kind of common sense, but download code directly from WordPress.org whenever possible. And this is for your actual WordPress sites. You know, I'm not talking about like premium things or premium plugins. But if you have a choice and it's in the WordPress library, download from there. So we talked about always upgrade your WordPress core plugins and things. And if you have WordPress 3.7 and later, then your core will automatically upgrade unless you turn that off. You can go into the WP config file and turn off the automatic upgrades. Okay, so there's a lot of security plugins out there. Just tons of them. If you type in WordPress security, there's thousands of them. These are four that, through a process of elimination, I've come to say, okay, these are ones that I would use. And you should use all of them. I would pick two at the most. But there's WordPress Security. It has an antivirus and acquire more security, bulletproof security, and all these, they don't have one or two things, they have multiple different things on it, but this is like the main things that they do. Bulletproof security changes your HT access file so that it's more secure. IP security does a ton of things to lock the other site. You can, IP security, you have different levels. You have like a red level, an orange level, and a lower level, I think it is. And you can choose to just do the red things or go all the way down to the simple things to change so that your site is more secure. But there's always a trade-off between having a site most secure and having it accessible for people to keep in mind.
Quick question here on this. I'm probably not a very naive creator. Mm-hmm. If your site is not taking in visitor material, strictly a display site, what are you trying to protect against?
From bots coming to your site, from people trying to get into your again.
Okay, but if you've done secure, strong passwords, and that's the admin, then why do you want not bots coming to your site?
You don't want malicious ones coming to your site.
So are you saying WordPress has some security holes? Or no? Quite. So I'm correctly naive.
So yes, even though you have strong passwords, you still want security plugins to put on your site. So the last one here is one that was built by some local people here. Jesse Freeman and Sam Hotchkiss, they're both active in this community here. But this group attack came out maybe 6 months ago, and it's cloud power. It protects your site against bot attacks. You have to sign up for this site, but that part of it's free. There's also a paid part, but it really, it's a great plugin and it protects your site and it tells you how many bots it's stopped from coming to your site. So, one, it has great people behind it, local community people, and it seems to be doing a great job on my sites. So I would say that's a great plugin to put in. And if you're looking at all of these together, I would say the two best ones to put in is IP security and a group protect. Okay, so in conclusion, WordPress.org has themes and plugins that are open source and community developed. Always remember that because you need to be a little bit cautious. I know that WordPress.org vets all these, but you should, you never know when something will get through or something will be added, and you can't always say that it's going to be clean. Keep all your plugins and themes up to date, and when you shouldn't ever change any core files. You could use a child theme or use, in some things they have a place to change CSS. But don't change any of your core files in WordPress or in your theme. You should always keep them outside of them so that when WordPress updates or your themes update, you won't have to read and make those changes. So, I just wanted people to know about these little tools. One is wpthemedetector.com. You just go to that site and put in a URL. theme that it's using usually. If somebody has a child theme, it will give whatever they name that child theme, but. Wow, this internet is slow here. Seems like it was working really fast this morning. You can go in and you can search for plugins. I don't know if there's something that specific for real estate. Have you seen it on other sites?
Well, I think there is. I mean, it's an XML feed that you can use.
Mm-hmm. But, so that's an XML feed, but are you, it's
yes,
an analysis of?
It's a source.
Yes.
For real estate
owners to subscribe to. So I think that would be more in a theme that would pull in that information for you. There might be some functionality. I'm not familiar. You might want to ask at the happiness bar if they have some suggestions for that.
Do you have any recommendations on plugins that can help manage right, but from a central dashboard at that time.
I'm still not sure what they were saying. You have different websites?
So you have more than one WordPress instance. Plugin that can manage the upgrades to get more than one of the sites.
There's a couple of services you can do that will bring all your sites into one place and you can upgrade all the plugins from there.
Right.
Manage WP.
Yeah, the WP is a good one. Thank you. Yes?
Earlier you said that the process for doing an upgrade, you should back it up, upgrade, I think you said all the plugins and themes, and then upgrade core. Why is it plugins and themes first and then core second?
Sometimes the core upgrading first, the plugins might not, if they weren't upgraded first, they might not be ready for that version.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Yep.
So if you're doing 3.9.2, the plugin may not be ready for that yet that you have deciding on your site. But if you upgrade the plugins first, you'll get the most updated plugins.
That makes sense.
Is that the one that is available in the gallery?
Okay, we're done. It's lunchtime.